Hello, I'm Yahtzee Croshaw.
And I'm the other one.
Did you hear someone talking, listeners? I didn't. Unless it was the grunting of a swine.
What'd I do this time?
What didn't you do? What you didn't do was show up at my house last week. Where were you, you big fonts?
Well, okay, I help out with the local fighting game community, and we were running Queensland's, major fighting game tournament for things like Street Fighter, Injustice, King of Fighters, Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3.
I see.
And between that and some assignment work, I was horribly busy.
How many people would you say showed up to that tournament?
About 108.
How many people would you say watch these videos every week?
I don't know.
Would you like to inform him, listeners, on Twitter, perhaps?
Yeah, it's funny, because people are like, what about your OCD? And it's like, I point that at university. That's how I do university. That all gets pointed at university.
Not OCD.
No, I used to have, like, actual problematic OCD. Like, I used to count syllables when I was younger, and there was, like, almost 2 years where I'd pre-count the syllables and sentences I was about to say, and everything was 10 syllables long.
Did you?
Yes.
How many syllables are in this? Gabriel, you're a fat ass.
7.
Very good.
It's kind of a joke now. It used, and like most things, it used to actually be a weird fucking disorder.
All right. What are we playing if it isn't immediately obvious?
Yeah, if it isn't immediately obvious, welcome to Earth. Enjoy your stay. This is a Grand Theft Auto San Andreas.
Of course it is. The slightly polarizing Grand Theft Auto.
Well, I quite enjoyed it. I liked the little RPG-y elements. I don't think they were too horrible. The worst ones I think were unnoticeable.
See, I like a GTA where you just fuck about.
Well, yeah. I mean, this one did have a fair bit of barrier to the amount of fucking about you could do. But
I did play the few starting missions prior to you coming over, and you better fucking appreciate it.
I wanted the ability for full free roam on, because what we are doing today, inspired a little bit by Yahtzee's Just Cause 2 playthrough, is cycling tour of San Andreas.
Wow.
So pack yourself a lovely picnic, nice. Get a nice playlist of acoustic guitar.
Get a nice thermos of tea, perhaps?
Yeah, a thermos of tea. I've got my cycling underwear and hat on.
I chose the outfit.
And we're going to go for a cycling tour of San Andreas.
All right then, that's enough of a build-up, I think.
I could really go some Simon and Garfunkel now.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
My dad once called them semen and fuckknuckle, and that's been making me laugh for about 20 years.
You and your dad.
Come on, dude. Semen and fuckknuckle, that's pretty funny.
It's not that funny.
It's great. Fuckknuckle.
I refuse to be amused.
The trees are lovely this time of year.
Yes, the 2D trees. Look at you sitting upright with a cock in your step.
I got one of those great sort of like semi-banana seat bikes from the 70s.
Yeah, that's got to be fucking painful in just your underpants. That's going to chafe against your big black ass.
Getting some serious bike ass. I don't have a big black ass. I'm like fit. Look at me. Yeah.
Yes, this game was a fairly polarizing one, as I recall. I think that's just because everyone's racist.
I gotta play as one of the Negras? Pretty much.
Although there is some quite genuine sounding dialogue for a game made in the north of England.
No one knows more about African American culture than nerdy white guys.
Of course.
That is.
I mean, they're the ones who buy all the records.
Yeah. I love me my NWA.
Can you ride
early
up those...
work like KRS-One?
Oh, your cycling skill's gone up now. You can ride up that staircase.
Awesome.
Or just toddle your way up this hill. Hello, officers.
Yep, I'm obeying the law.
Look at you escaping the ghetto, many young black men have dreamed.
Yeah, just as an illustration, we'll go to the map screen and I'll show you our itinerary.
Yes, despite being polarizing, this had the largest sandbox there had been in GTA up to that point.
I think a fair bit of
possibly even since.
Mm. I think a fair bit of sandbox variety too. Like there was
there's like
very
three
dense cities
yeah.
So we're gonna head down here to East Beach. Gonna hit the freeway on my bicycle because that's safe. Toddle on up.
So the first city is a takeoff of Los Angeles, if I recall correctly. The next one is San Francisco.
Might do a loop and cut through here so we can get a little bit of a look of the city. Then we're going to, I think head up to the boondocks, come around, follow on down through yonder.
I think that's San Francisco. The other one's Las Vegas.
Mm. Yeah, that's right.
Those three notoriously close American cities that aren't in different states.
We're going to see as much of it as we can, and then we're going to end with a nice cycle up to the top of the mountain.
Okay. Well, let's stop looking at the map.
Well, you need to plan your bicycle tours. You can't just like ride off into the fucking...
Well, the fun ones you do.
You and your anarchistic cycling company.
I never did play much of this one. I played, as I said, a few missions before recording, and I did some of the repetitive gym workout shit you do to build your muscle mass up, and I thought, that's enough for me.
It's interesting that that's how you'd spend time in this game. Well, hey there, guy.
Well, it told me to. Now, I did play quite a bit of Vice City.
Have a wander down here and just check out the beach.
I think San Andreas and Vice City both were back when GTA was kind of hard.
Mm.
Like you only had one shot with the missions and there was no mid-mission checkpoint, as I recall. Well, you could try the mission again.
You can see here some...
Wow, what a great cycling tour of this repeated texture.
Oh, look, there's one of our lovely rural types.
Hey, someone on a riding mower on the highway. It's like that film.
Like that movie we saw that time.
I'm sure...
Pedal, 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 car!
Yeah.
Metal. Completely. I'm a cyclist! I have right-of-way everywhere!
I am the most energy-efficient being in the world.
Fuck you! I'm allowed to do this. Hey, you dick.
Come on, man. We're losing our peaceful intentions for this cycling tour.
We're back. It's okay. I'm calm now.
And look how healthy cycling is.
Yeah.
It's like living in Denmark, where everyone
but
cycles.
With black people.
How did that whole fighting game tournament go, anyway? Let me guess. Someone punched someone a lot.
Well, I didn't do too well.
I'm filled with scorn for one-on-one fighting games, as you know. Which one's your specialty, would you say?
I very don't care about your extremely ill-informed opinion on fighting games.
Yes, all right.
It's like asking me about real-time strategy games. I don't understand them. It does not mean you can't enjoy them, but I just don't get them.
Oh, I understand fighting games. I just don't see the point. It's just about memorizing all the moves that...
I can bunny hop!
...particular characters can do.
How do I bunny hop? Let me bunny hop.
Small things, please. Small
it's
minds,
a me,
my friend.
CJ! Whee!
Carl Johnson, he a buster. Well, that's what I gathered from the cutscenes in which I didn't really understand the language.
Please use more of the urban slang.
Carl Johnson is a buster. I've gathered that. What else?
What another fuck? Is that the same tractor?
Man, he's living it up.
You white bread, get off the freeway! So the problem with these tournaments is they're good and it's great to see, to have some...
That man on that riding mower is going to go home and complain about you on the internet.
Good. But it's also really disheartening because I get my ass fucking handed to me and I'm not shit. Like, I'm probably a C grade player in these games.
Yes, every single person on Earth is at exactly the right level of game proficiency where they're not a newbie, but they're not, some kind of pathetic time waster who wastes their life with it. Everyone is at that level of skill. Everyone is normal. That's what they consider themselves, anyway.
It is a time sink to get professionally good at these things.
What are we doing in Hobo Town?
I don't know. I'm gonna check the map. Where are we?
Did you play GTA 5?
Got a little off track. Okay.
Because GTA 5 was based in the same geographical area, although the sandbox seems quite different. But this area is reminding me of the sort of redneck town where you start off as Trevor in that game.
Probably is.
That's one thing we could talk about. The GTA series as a whole.
I haven't played 5. I've been wanting to, but it's just one of those... I kind of got absorbed into Dark Souls, and then
the
anomalous happened.
The anomalously vastly popular GTA series, where you just have to sort of say you're bringing one out, and it immediately makes its money back. There's a blockage in the road...
This could hinder my ability to go on a riding tour.
Can you swim across the water?
I think this is GTA, you can't swim across shit.
No, you can swim in San Andreas.
Okay. That's right.
I know
right.
that much.
I don't know, what are the odds I'll get a 5-star rating?
Pretty good, but that's part of the fun.
Maybe there's another bridge.
Yes, GTA is certainly not a series that's been afraid to mix things up a bit with each one. Because
I think that's a good intention to go into these things with. I mean,
I guess. I mean, up to GTA 4, they'd always be in like vastly different cities.
Mm. Uh-oh.
Then GTA 4, they decided it was going to be about characters now.
For good and for ill.
I don't know, I liked Nico Bellic as a character in GTA 4.
I like Nico as well, actually.
I thought he was a cool dude.
Well, there was surprising moments of actual depth to him. You know,
well, that was kind of the problem. I mean, he was a good character for a serious game, but GTA 4 is not a serious game. This is the series in which an internet cafe is called Twat.
Oh, Rockstar.
It's like one of those little conversational speed bumps you run into. I was listening to like that game and like your cousin says, as part of a tutorial mission, you should go to Twat. And I'm like, I'm sorry?
Trying to take this... trying to enjoy the recovery of someone who's been in like war. Yeah, GTA.
Yeah.
I bet we haven't unlocked enough. I bet I'm going to be completely like stuck having to do...
Well, they just have to ride around Compton. Straight out of Compton and then straight back into Compton. Yeah.
Straight back into Compton. Broke motherfucker named Ice Cube. Band broke up. Solo career not that good.
You're just stringing words together at this point. I don't know what you're on about.
Welcome to the hip hop.
Oh, the hipping and the hopping. Yeah. Yes, I've heard of this phenomenon. What about there? Can you go down there?
I don't know. There's a big yellow sign. You didn't unlock enough.
Fucking yellow.
I blame you.
Oh, I wasn't going to waste more time of my week than was needed, frankly. We'll just make our own entertainment. Remember how that used to work?
No. Alright. Oh.
Well, that was
fun.
That was entertaining. I hope you're getting your money's worth, viewer. Yes, GTA 4 I quite liked. I didn't think I actually finished it. I mean, I like the character, as I say, but a lot of the gameplay I could take or leave. I mean, I think it was the Saints Row that took the crown from GTA in terms of wacky crime sandbox.
It really did.
Where they just rolled with it and had fun. And became fun. Increasingly so. And GTA just went all serious and moody on us. Okay, can you just climb over that on foot? Shall we see what happens if you do?
I'm going to go for a swim.
Okay, then. Use the movement controls to move around in the water. Slow down.
Well,
this is some revolutionary shit. Swim underwater a bit.
Whee!
See, a lot of video games allow you to jump out of water like that. That is not a thing that happens.
Completely fucking...
You cannot do that. Blimey, right. There's something badly wrong with this water. But then I suppose this is LA. It's vibrant green.
That was a time when we were impressed by all this.
Yeah, I mean, look at the lighting effects on this game. They're fucking awful.
Is this just because it's the Steam version? Like, is there like a not translate to PC well button?
Oh, no, I've played the PS2 version. It was shit.
Yeah.
Like, as it tends to be the case, the Steam version improves the graphics. And it's funny we should mention that.
Yeah, it leads on to at least one of our topics, which is...
Dark Souls 2.
Getting
the announcement being that the graphical fidelity had to be taken down quite a few notches in order for it to be playable on
the pictures,
PS3 and 360.
Yeah, the sort of little side by side that we got, or at least I saw, where there was like fire shooting up out of the ground, and it's like, here's the lighting that they had in the ads, and here's the shit miserable actual gameplay.
See, I don't know. I'm not the kind of person who really notices graphics. It gets to a certain point of good, and I'm like, yeah, fine, I can work
with
it.
I'm kind of in that camp as well, but this was like a side-by-side. Like, it's easy when there's a side-by-side.
Well, of course, if there's a side-by-side.
That's what I'm talking about here.
But they do say the upcoming Steam release of Dark Souls 2 will have the graphics as it was meant to have. Just another reason to turn away from consoles forever. Though it does raise one question for me, and why they never considered releasing Dark Souls 2 for the next-gen consoles.
That does seem a bit weird. Is there another, like, you know, are they a little tricky to develop for, perhaps?
Well, all consoles are tricky to develop for.
I wonder if I can get into this.
Press F.
That's what I'm pushing.
Ooh, there you go. Now, can you jump off that onto the shore? Yes, we did it! We're fugitives. We escaped you, damn game.
Yeah.
Now we are the winner.
Alright,
four-star rating.
What? Oh, come on!
Trespasser!
Black guy, get him!
Well, so much for boring games. This is exactly what happened with the Just Cause 2 plan, isn't it?
Look, I'm leaving, please don't hurt me.
They gotta make an example of black men, you know. Ah, look at some of that mature GTA humor in action there with the name of this boat.
The pot.
You know, I think GTA 4 has one of my favorite pieces of dialogue in a game.
Mm.
It's a scene where Nico Bellic is talking about his history back in the old country, back in the war. Look at you.
All right.
You're the best. And he's talking to, like, the wife of a mob boss.
Let's replace the Simon and Garfunkel with some drowning pool, because now we can't go on our bike tour.
Let the bodies hit the floor. Yeah, Nico's talking to, like, this spiritual woman, saying, don't you ever worry for your... She says something like, don't you ever worry for your soul. And Nico says, when you go into a village and find all the children from the schoolhouse lined up along the side, each with their throat cut and their hands cut off, you realize that the creature that can do this doesn't have a soul. And it's just one of my favorite character moments, because it just paints Nico as just this man who wants to open up and who carries this darkness around with him that he's trying to escape from, but it just follows him wherever he goes. And as I say, kind of out of place in a GTA game, but never mind.
Alright, fuck this shit. I'm hitting a woman and taking a motorcycle.
Okay, then.
Police don't care.
Well, so much for the cycling tour.
Alright, well, let's have a look-see.
So what's the plan now, Stan? Let's just map out as far as we can go. We can probably do all that countryside.
I hope so, because I really did want to end on the mountain. Like,
okay.
That was...
we'll see how we go.
Okay, is that a ramp?
You gonna motorbike on the ramp?
I probably am, yes.
Well, have fun with that. Yes, we were talking about Dark Souls 2, rather. I don't want to talk too much about it because my review for that's coming up this week. I don't want to accidentally repeat any points I've made.
Like you did last time.
Although I did, after I'd written the review, after I wrote the review, I finished the game, and once I'd finished it, I kind of thought a little worse of it, so I'm going to write down some additional thoughts in my follow-up column, I think. Because, you know, yeah, the best you could say is it's more Dark Souls. Dark Souls is good.
I think it was, like, we sort of discussed this in one of our many private conversations of which you are not privy. In that,
I'm half privy because I'm usually drunk.
Where we both came to the conclusion that more of a spiritual successor would probably have been a better way to go. Like, it doesn't feel like there should have been an immediate sequel to Dark Souls.
Well, Dark Souls was the spiritual successor to Demon's Souls, wasn't it?
And I mean, like, this, I think that it would have been better waited out and maybe released later into the next generation or.
Ah, well, the problem with that, Gabe, is that Dark Souls 1 was really popular, and everyone with lots of money said, hey, let's make another of the popular thing.
Let's do that again!
Eclipsed Demon's Souls in popularity, so I'm wondering if there's much worth in going back and playing Demon's Souls.
If I wouldn't mind having a look.
Well, it seems Dark Souls is the one that took off.
Oh, Billy hurt!
But you know, if there's any game that would be really fitting for an next-gen console, it's Dark Souls, because it's all about the grand sweeping vistas and the big fights with the great big skyboxes showing all the places you're about to go to.
That is one thing I still do love about Dark Souls. And really distance that you can interact with. It gives relevance to the space.
And fucking massive big boss fights.
Yeah.
Like the Gaping Dragon. Imagine the gaping...
That was a heck... Like, that boss fight was easy, but that was a heck of an intro. Like,
it was
that
a,
thing...
It was impressive.
Yeah.
You know, deceptively easy, but impressive. Oh, bums. See, this is what it's like being a black man. It's metaphors.
Yeah.
It's like the glass stop sign. Check your privilege again.
Wouldn't be happening if I was white. Okay, look up on your tablet if there's a quick way of getting the PC version to just unlock all areas, because there has to be.
Oh, must I?
Yes.
Fine.
Look, only if it's easy. Normally you can bring up a console and type something in and, like, spawn weapons and shit.
Alright, well, be sparkling and interesting while I look it up.
Sweet fucking Jesus. Alright, what's one of our other topics? I've been reading some interesting things about The Amazing Spider-Man 2, which I sort of hope harkens back a little bit to Spider-Man 2 on the GameCube, as it
and,
is.
And good luck with that.
Well, it is a hope tempered by, you know, an understanding that it could easily be shattered. I'm not going to sit there and go, it's going to be fantastic, but I would like, I did really enjoy that. I would like a modern iteration of it with the accompanying goodies and extras that the pretty modern gaming has. But,
well, it wasn't so much...
I'm tired of life! Racing! Aww.
Pity you don't drown in this game. I got a list of cheats here. I'm just looking for the one that opens up everything. Increase wanted level, don't need that. Oh, well, maybe we could use that.
Yeah, I might be able to decrease.
Yeah, vehicles. Cars float away when hit. That might be fun.
This is... If you're wondering why I always hum like sort of a... Is it Girl from Ipanema? Yeah, I think it's Girl from Ipanema. It's because it's one of my favorite scenes in Cable Guy. When Jim Carrey is just, like, sleeping in a crawl space. Not sleeping, but he's just, like, laying in a crawl space on the phone. And he pretends to be on hold, and he just really psychotically sings, like, either Way to San Jose or Girl from Ipanema. I can't remember. One of those little hold songs that you hear all the time.
The following cheats were not implemented. Drive on water, do nothing, hookers pay you.
Do nothing. That's... We can manage that one by ourselves, Rockstar.
Okay, there doesn't appear to be any cheats for unlocking the world, but there is one for clearing a wanted level, so that might help.
Alright, we're going to do this.
Okay.
How do I put that in?
It just says type the cheats while playing without pausing.
Okay, what do I have to type?
The phrase is, turn down the heat, no pauses. No spaces, I mean.
Okay, turn down the heat. Alright, we're gonna give this a try.
Can you guess what the cheat is for making the wanted level go up?
Fuck the police.
No,
turn
it's...
Turn up the heat?
Yes, it's turn up the heat. Well done, you. What were you talking about? Spider-Man?
Yeah, just, you know, I am a fan of the gameplay mechanic and...
Well, in Spider-Man 2, as we've said, it treated the movement like, you know, as the main gameplay mechanic. All the web-swinging and stuff.
Yeah.
With your race challenges and all that. Oh, I'm liking this music.
Yahtzee really likes his hair metal and power ballads.
What's wrong with power ballads?
Nothing, I'm just...
Why does your wake always green in this game? the river's just full of
the dye
of
is coming off my shirt. For God's sake, give me a bit of ground I can...
Well, don't go back to the other shore.
I'm not, I'm just...
Don't go that way either.
Swimming around, having a look. Alright, that looks...
Okay.
Okay, now it's gonna happen. Probably. Right.
Wait for it. No, we're okay so far. And there's a bicycle for you. Oh no, it's a motorbike.
One of the new motored
Oops, four
bicycles.
Stars. Four stars. Okay. Turn down the heat. There you go. Oh, just came straight back again. Well, that's not going to work, is it?
All right, I'm on a bike. I can escape this.
This is supposed to be a boring playthrough.
Uh-oh, tire's gone.
This always happens with sandbox games. It's almost like they're designed to be fun.
All right. Our goal.
You just got your heart set on that mountain, haven't you?
I'm getting... to the fucking mountain if it kills me. Okay, so if we follow this and hang a left off the off the,
I'm just picturing, is this like a,
be able to get us there, okay.
Like a tragic Thelma and Louise like drama now.
Ah shit,
well,
shit,
that
shit,
didn't
shit.
That tragic Thelma and Louise drama didn't last very long, did it?
Get on the bike, CJ.
I'm just picturing you going through an odyssey of pain and despair and then finally reaching a destination but getting shot at the last moment. The last thing you see through your dying eyes is the top of the mountain you always dreamed of.
Yeah.
And you reach out a hand as your view fades and blurs. And then mournful piano music fades up as the sound effects of shouting policemen fades down.
Is that The Outsiders? Which I'm sure there's...
No, I'm just describing a basic
Rumblefish,
sort of...
Rumblefish, I think it was Rumblefish. I'm trying to think of actual movies and books that have had that.
I'm just describing a basic sort of trope there.
Yeah. I think Rumblefish ended that way. Yeah, it was Rumblefish.
Funnily enough, what I was picturing was the scene at the end of Braveheart, where Mel Gibson is dying and he sees the ghost of his love in the crowd.
I cannot see shit.
Well, that's probably because you're a black man, and you're very hard to see in a dark area.
Come on, drive, drive, must get to mountain!
I don't think tapping the forward button does anything when you're not on a
normal bike. I'm not tapping forward,
bike.
I'm tapping left and right in an attempt to sort of steer my ass.
Well, that's something.
The wheels come off my bike. Here's a rumor. Ah, Express Yourself, I love this song.
So Dark Souls 2 is basically just another reason not to buy next-gen consoles, it seems.
It is, because, I mean, isn't there some new graphics card that's some insane humdinger and it's like a whole $150, which is affordable even for me?
Well, if it's like just a lone thing, what the hell developer is going to support it?
It's one of the famous brands. I don't know, I don't really know, like, graphics card stuff.
No, me neither. I just bought a pre-baked Alienware computer. Why are you asking me?
You just walked in and were just like, can you give me computer?
Computer, play games. Me
wanna, I wanna play Nintendo.
Produce copy of PC World magazine.
Shit.
With a double page spread on Arkham City, pointing and going, won't play Batman.
You went off the cliff.
Won't be Batman.
Shit. God damn it, no!
Sorry, sir, we cannot.
My bike fell off the cliff.
Sorry, sir, our product will not turn you into Batman. You ruined Christmas! You're gonna run up the mountain now.
I am going to get as far as I can get.
I think exactly what I prophesied is gonna happen.
Yeah.
I think I might as well just start.
I was hoping, because that was kind of a touching prophecy. There it is! Oh god, I'm winded, I can't run. I hope this isn't a police car. Sweet.
Here, far, wherever you are, I'll be here where I've lived there. My heart will go on.
Humming, coming at ya!
So yes, Spider-Man 2. Spider-Man 2 was good, and you were saying the new Amazing Spider-Man is going to be open world again, yes?
Well, yes, and it's putting up some claims that things like the L and R buttons will relate to, you know, kind of where you're shooting your webbing, and
yeah.
That there'll be you can't just web onto clouds.
It's easy to talk a big game.
I know, which is why I'm not saying this is going to be the greatest thing ever, but I, you know, merely that I like that these suggest a direction of intent that I am in support of.
Because there's been plenty of sandbox Spider-Man games after Spider-Man 2 that were shit nevertheless.
Yes.
Like Spider-Man 3, for example, the movie tie-in.
I didn't play that one too much. Oh, wieners! Shit.
This is turning into the Just Cause 2 video again, isn't it?
Up the mountain,
in your boxer shorts, quickly. We'll get a heartwarming coming-of-age film out of this yet. So Spider-Man 3 was open world, it was shit. Spider-Man... Well, the first Amazing Spider-Man tie-in game was open world and shit. Spider-Man Web of Shadows was open world and shit. So, open world Spider-Man being shit is more the exception than the rule at this point.
Where are these guys coming from?
From space. We'll be here when my heart will go on. Yeah, you're gonna get a shot. Or not, because the police seem to be having trouble with the slope. They're not as athletic as a black man. Or they'll just teleport in from space. Well, you're not making this any easier on yourself.
That's not work. Shit!
Our heart will go on, as if far wherever you are.
I wanted mountain. Fuck it. God damn it.
Take your soulful ending with dignity, man.
Ah, fuck you, lady. I'm mad at the world, and you're gonna pay.
All right, can we come up with a new goal for ourselves?
Well, how about you do that? I had a goal.
Okay, you have to collect 100 dead prostitutes. That's the spirit of GTA games, right? At least that's what Fox News tells me.
I don't know if I can collect them.
To collect their souls. And then use them to create a magic weapon.
Alright, is there like a weapon cheat?
The hooker blade.
Hooker soul sword. It, yeah.
I'm sure there was a weapons cheat, yes. Oh, there's a couple of weapons cheats. Do you want weapon set 1, weapon set 2, or weapon set 3?
What's 3?
That cheat is U Z U M Y M W. Okay, use the scroll wheel. You have a chainsaw, a silenced gun, an SMG, a rocket launcher.
Oh, this makes up for my miserable life.
Hey, that wasn't necessarily a prostitute in that car. You're getting outside. You're a loose cannon, hooker cop CJ. Why, I'm pretty sure those are not prostitutes at all.
I'm all out of fucks.
Oh wait, money came out of them. Continue.
I didn't want the fucking thing.
Alright, well, while you do that, why don't you tell us a little more about what has been leaked about Amazing Spider-Man 2, the game? So this is why we do boring games in this segment.
Well, I was trying to do a very boring playthrough of this, but you're lazy not doing the thing I asked you to do, Ness.
You told me just to play one or two missions, and that was all I had time to do.
Until the map was unlocked.
Well, I think it takes quite a few missions to unlock the map.
I just hate everything now.
Well, I guess keep doing this until it gets tedious, I suppose.
Which it does.
Yeah. Yep, yawn explosion. That's a pretty slow-moving rocket you're launching there.
It, like, toddles along.
Yeah, literally fuck the police. And what's that you got? Oh, it's a satchel charge. Yes, come on. Amazing Spider-Man 2 facts.
Well, yeah, my brain's off now because I'm fucking having to shoot things. Spider-Man 2. Oh, yeah. And that there's going to be... like this thing where... you have like a hero rating that's sort of dictated by... you know, the Daily Bugle. So if you do a lot of good things, you get good reports. If you do a lot of bad things, J. Jonah Jameson calls you a menace. And
see, that's what you told me earlier, and I'm thinking that sounds like a pretty clear-cut moral choice mechanic to me.
I don't... I think it's more like... I don't mind moral choices as kind of fluff.
Okay,
like,
I've got a mission for you now.
Okay.
You have to drive around the city as a responsible driver.
Okay.
Starting from now, obviously, after having run over that policeman.
All right. Well,
we'll escape your wanted level,
we'll
and then
escape this, yeah,
and then be a responsible citizen. Yeah, your task is to get a tattoo, a haircut, a meal, and a change of clothes, while being a sensible driver. Why are you changing the? Radio stations.
Because I want the one that has all the hip-hop songs I like.
I hate hip-hop. Play the 80s channel.
Yeah, it's my car, my radio.
Well, I've got the iPad.
Great.
Yes, I've never liked moral choice in games.
I think it's always been executed really, really shittily. Like, Dishonored had one of the most lazy fucking moral choice structures ever. Where you can't even tell what's happening exactly, and then you just get insanely black and white endings. So, and that's a problem. Yeah. Like, black and white's not moral. Morality is grey, so you just... you killed the wrong guy twice. Evil. Everything's evil forever now.
Well, killing people is always crossing the line.
Yeah. Okay, what's that? Is that food? Is it a 69 cent store? What do I get at the 69 cent store?
I don't know what it is. Why don't you investigate?
Alright, well, let's pull over and park. That doesn't seem like the right way to park there, guys.
Well, yeah. Lead by example, man. Just.
Oh, wow, it's got nothing to do with me.
Yeah.
I just gunned a guy down.
Continue, citizens. Continue, officers. You fine upholders of the law. Yes, get yourself some nappies to replace your current one.
I do look like I've shit myself, though, because of the amazing lighting and texturing.
I did like the Infamous games. I picked up Infamous Second Son, I haven't started playing it yet.
Go Space Monkey.
And the main thing about Infamous is... there's that classic sense of humor again. They crawled from Uranus. I don't get it.
This was like Galaga 3 or Galaxian 3, I'm pretty sure, or Gradius.
I don't know.
No, I'm more trying to remember for my own business.
So yeah, I liked the Infamous games, but that was more in spite of the moral choice than than partly because of it.
I think it's fundamentally a very tough thing to do in a game.
Well, the problem with moral choice I always have is that the choice runs through the whole game. They say, are you going to be good or bad at this point? Are you going to be good or bad at this point? But there's usually no point in going from one to the other.
There's never a middle. That's my problem, is there's never the subtlety is.
You might as well just say at the start, I'm going to do all good or I'm going to do all evil.
Yeah.
Especially, and in Infamous particularly, you get the best rewards when you're all the way good or all the way evil. I think the only game I can think of that had a moral choice and a neutral option was The Suffering 2. Did you ever play The Suffering?
No.
Well,
actually, didn't some of the Silent Hills had fairly multiple endings.
Yeah, but it wasn't a moral thing. It was just based on.
Weren't there in like Silent? Wasn't there things in Silent Hill 2 where you had to like deal with shit that you would?
No.
Yeah. I thought we were dealing with some emotional, or, you know. Stuff,
yeah, but none of the endings really
reflected that.
Judge you morally or anything.
Except dog ending, which was, you know, a very clear, obvious comment.
The thing about Silent Hill 2 is that the bad thing you've done is fixed.
Hmm.
Everything in the game is after the fact, and the endings are just how you redeem yourself because of what you did. Like, in one ending you commit suicide, in another ending you find the ability to forgive yourself. And that might be interpreted as a good and bad ending, but personally I think the suicide ending is the one that fits the story better.
So, I would agree.
Yes. Have you played it?
Most of the way through, and then my hard drive crashed and I lost all my saves.
Oh dear. Well, now you get the pleasure of playing it all over again.
Alright, where should I get... Lower back, gotta get a stamp, tramp stamp.
Of course.
Angel or dagger. I can't afford these.
Well, guess you better go make some money then. Although I'm not sure how you do that. Maybe you just wait for the police to gun down your fellow black people and take the money from their corpses. Fuck the police.
The rich ecosystem of the urban economy.
It's not like Skyrim, this is it? There's no legitimate way to make money.
No, you're always doing criminal activities of some description.
Well, guess you better kill some whores then. Yeah, you're still a responsible citizen as long as the police never notice what you've done. That's the rule. Oh, that works.
That was loaded.
That worked amazingly well.
I literally don't have enough of my tattoo.
Yeah, actually, you killed a banger, didn't you?
Yeah.
That's great. That's vigilante work. You're still a responsible citizen. Continue.
Get your tattoo. All right, I'm going to get my reward tattoo.
Yes, this is working.
Yeah. This is my vigilante tramp stamp. It is how they will know me.
Yes, you get another tramp stamp for every gang banger you kill.
Alrighty. Angel, fuck ya.
Yeah, so wouldn't say the Silent Hill endings were a moral judgment. Maybe they were in some of the Western developed ones. Like Silent Hill Downpour, I think, definitely had some judgment endings.
Okay, I might go home and change my clothes.
That was the really dumb thing in Silent Hill Downpour. You got a bad ending if you killed monsters.
Why?
Not humans, if you kill monsters. what you were supposed to do, apparently, was just smash them into submission until they were lying on the floor and still breathing. And not stomp them to death. Even though stomping things to death is part of the fun of Silent Hill. I don't think that was a banger.
Mummy didn't hug me.
Excuse me, mate, could you give me a lift? No? Okay. before you. What other games of moral choice? Oh yeah, Mass Effect was another game where there's no reward for being in between the two.
There's a general problem with middle ground in a lot of things. Like when a game will have like character classes and stuff, you get very little reward for being anywhere in the middle.
And the other thing is that the bad ending always tends to feel like a non-standard game over to me.
Yeah, it feels like you have failed. It's hard to do failure in a video game because you are conditioned to not like it.
Yeah, it's hard to have a bad ending and have it seem like that you've succeeded.
I think it would be possible if you develop the character and situation enough that it felt... Again, like, I think the suicide, you know, ending in Silent Hill 2 would be probably a solid example of that.
In Violent Kill 2.
I wonder if I can get a haircut for $65, but
yeah,
I can't.
I remember, years back, someone asked me what I'd like for a present, and I think I asked for one of the Silent Hill games. And, they couldn't find it, but later they revealed that they misheard me and was looking for Silent Kill. And I was like, is that what you think all video games are, you racist?
Yay!
That's kind of boring, but never mind.
I'll get a fun one when I get a bit more money. See, there's like blue hair, red hair, green hair, Elvis hair. Ooh, gotta get the $1,000. Gotta make that green. I'm gonna go to my house and get changed, I think, or maybe, yeah.
No.
So I'll stab to death another banger. Where are you?
Yes.
I am vengeance. I am the knight. I am broke.
Well, here we are, back straight into Compton.
I had such a nice cycling tour planned.
So whenever I play a game with a moral choice, I always go out of my way to go for the good ending.
So do I.
Because I know that's gonna be the ending that feels like an ending, isn't
yeah.
it?
Or feels like, yeah, it feels like a resolution.
I'll tell you one game that had a pseudo-moral choice at the end where all the endings kind of felt like a resolution, and that was Singularity.
Haven't played that.
It kind of fell off the radar, and it's mostly a fairly unremarkable game, but it's actually surprisingly good in the end. Because you end up with a choice where you have to choose either to kill an evil general guy who's offering you power, a nice scientist guy who might be, not telling you something, or you could kill both and then just, just walk away and disappear and leave the world to its own devices. Or you could kill neither and do something that results in your death. And I think that leads to the best ending. But it was interesting because whatever ending you chose, it gave you an epilogue that felt like a natural conclusion. And the funny thing was, the ending where you side with the evil general man didn't even feel like a bad ending. I mean, they do a little epilogue where it said your relationship with the guy eventually fell down.
Mm-hmm.
But it turned out that you were the one who betrayed him in the end. He was... Like, contrary to expectation, he was entirely at his word.
You're the jerk.
Yeah, I kind of liked that.
Look.
You're the kind of evil guy...
I'm only stabbing
who...
her because she might have money. Hey, there we go.
I guess, for all his faults, that guy at least stuck to his principles, which you did not.
I'm poor. Give me some cash.
Yes, it was a funny game, that Singularity. A couple of good ideas, but... It just was sort of hampered by trying to be Bioshock and trying to be Half-Life and trying to be Time Shift.
It's an awful lot of things.
Well, yes, that's the problem with a lot of games.
Try be one of those and you'll do all right.
That's the problem with a lot of games these days. They're all trying to be a whole bunch of things.
This is what I mean. It's okay to copy, but copy simply and copy well. It's the whole God of everything's God of War but thing. It's like, I like God of War. If you want to copy God of War, it's fine. You might get an interesting game out of it. I'm not opposed to that, especially if it's a licensed game.
God of War's been copying God of War and producing a lot of uninteresting games.
Yeah, I suppose.
I think you gotta have a selling point. I mean, even if your selling point is just God of War but better, that does not count as a change of clothes.
Yes, it does. The Steam pads had some changes.
Has it?
Yeah, where they put like an actual... What the... Okay, space, remove item. Okay, return back.
Yeah, it's a bit weird, the PC controls in this. It's
fucking baffling. I
had a real problem with the analog stick on the joypad, so we're having to use keyboard.
Okay, I haven't taken off the item that I wanted to remove. That's... I thought I did. I thought I came out and was like, it was off.
I'm seeing why this is quite a polarizing game now.
Space select. Okay, remove items.
Remove.
Torso.
Okay. Then you press space to keep.
Oh, okay, so I just press space again after
that.
Yeah,
you press space to preview, and then press space again to keep.
Alright. Close change.
There you go.
Now you can all see my fancy angel lower back tat.
Are you going to put some trousers on as well?
No. I want to buy different trousers. I haven't earned the right to have fancy clothes yet.
See, this is just internalized guilt. This is internalized racism.
Look at it. Look at it.
That's kind of elaborate for a tramp stamp. How are you supposed to aim for that?
How many tramp stamps have you seen? If you think that's elaborate for a tramp stamp, it's like the. It's like how one makes...
Well, I've seen a lot of tramp stamps, and I know that they're usually isolated to the lower back. That's going all the way up the spine, that is. And around to the...
They get on up there.
And around the mid-back muscles as well.
They get on up there.
Well, there's a difference between tramp stamp and back tattoo. What you got there, I'd say, is a back tattoo.
Kind of a fusion. Hey, you're an opposing gang member.
I'm not sure he is, actually. I think the opposing gang wears purple.
Look, he's wearing red.
Okay, I guess he was wearing the wrong colours.
Yeah, that's enough to get you killed.
Where are you from, bro?
Where are you from?
I'm from the West Midlands.
Ireland does... Fuck me! Ow!
I guess that was a gang lady.
How am I not?
Yeah,
fuck it.
Sisters doing it for themselves. Fend off that pants-wearing maniac. Better get some food.
I'll just... Shirtless guy walks into KFC with knife.
Yeah, that's how you can tell that this was a game about black LA gangs written by white people from the north of England, is because there's a Blackadder reference in it.
Okay, is this giving me health? Oh, it is too, okay.
Because there's a line in Blackadder Goes Forth, like just before he has to go out and die on the battlefield, he says, "I think the phrase rhymes with clucking bell."
Not unless you've come up with some brilliant plan to get us out of this, Baldrick. Nope. Well, it's gonna have to wait.
Now you're completely butchering the quotes there, my friend.
Yeah, I can't remember it entirely. Yeah, you do it.
I have a plan, sir. Really, Baldrick? A cunning and subtle one? Yes, sir. As cunning as a fox that's just been made Professor of Cunning at Oxford University? Yes, sir. And then someone in the background yells, "On the signal, company will advance." And Blackadder says, "Well, I'm afraid it'll have to wait. Whatever it was, I'm sure it was better than the plan I had to get out of this by pretending to be mad. I mean, who would notice another madman around here?" And then a very tragic and memorable ending happened.
Very tragic, very memorable.
I actually had this one episode on tape. I got all the episodes of Red Dwarf on tape. This was the one episode of Blackadder I had on tape. Growing up. Watching over and over again, because we didn't have YouTube.
Rather remarkably sad, I think, you know.
Yeah, but
I think Darling... realizing, like, and I think, was it Stephen Fry's character in that was particularly good, where he's not evil, he's just distant.
He's just, yeah, he's just the, you know, the armchair, the classic armchair general.
The embodiment of this thing, just so distant from the actual, you know, horrors of war.
Saying, the Germans will never expect if we attempt an attack upon their trenches for the 18th time this month.
What else is happening? Sony's got a VR device. Is it, like, am I the only one really surprised that VR is kicking off and Nintendo wasn't responsible for it?
Perhaps there's still some bad memories on that front.
Yeah, because, I mean, Nintendo's turned a lot of their weird failures into, like, motion control. That was the Power Glove. Massive failure. Wii sold like fuck.
Well, I get what you're saying, because, I would hardly expect Sony to attempt anything that hadn't been proven to make money.
Yeah, this is rather, you know, actually fucking daring.
I mean, Nintendo's the one that usually takes the daring hardware leaps. for better or ill. And everyone else just sort of played safe once it was established it worked.
Oh, remember?
Like here comes the move and here comes the connect. This is completely new.
God, the move.
Look at how innovative we're being.
Why? Why just do nothing would be better than the move.
I think I made the point once that this only works if you force us to use it. And if it turns out it revolutionizes our lives, then great. Yeah, if it doesn't, you will fail more hugely than you would have done otherwise, but if you succeed, you'll succeed pretty fucking hard. See, people don't want to leave their comfort zones.
The move was so embarrassing.
If you have a console that has the move and a standard controller as well, everyone will say, we've only ever made and wanted to play games that use the existing controller. Just want to continue doing that.
It's a legitimate risk, to sit there and go, this is how you are going to play this now.
Sometimes people do have to be dragged kicking and screaming into the now. Sometimes you're wrong to attempt to do that.
Mm.
But, you only find this out with
only
hindsight.
Yep.
Gosh, how philosophical we're being. Because I think I've made this point a couple of times in videos. If you ask people what they want, they'll say, we want what we already like. And that goes fucking nowhere, does
it? Yeah, well, what was the thing about fucking Portal 2? Where it's like, we've got this new character called Cave Johnson.
Yeah, we're going to
like GLaDOS! Alright, we're going to shoehorn some GLaDOS in. Like Cave Johnson now!
That's what pissed me off.
Yeah.
Because
it was going to be all Cave.
Because Portal 1, that was fine. It worked in itself. It was a enclosed story with nowhere to go for the ending. Then they just sort of tacked on somewhere to go for the ending and then just sort of dallied around for a while.
I mean, they managed to work it in nicely, and I think GLaDOS's line of goodbye, sir, was actually really, really
touching. I think the single player in that game was flabby and didn't work as well as the single player in the previous game. Because part of the single player in the previous game was that it was a fast one. It made you think it was just going to be a quirky puzzle game with some ancillary character attached to it. And then the ancillary character becomes a larger plot.
Yeah, no, it suddenly expanded.
Suddenly it's trying to kill you. And when you're trying to work off something like that hinged on a sort of surprise, you're never going to be able to recreate that, so you might as well just do something new.
I don't know,
Is that a hooker? It's a woman in a GTA game.
You will have money. Shit.
Damn it. Hey, he didn't have as much money as the previous guy dressed like him. Maybe the first guy you killed was the celebrity trendsetter.
Yeah, he was handsome McMoney. I don't know, see, for me, Portal 2 was made by J.K. Simmons' fantastic delivery of excellent comedic writing.
Yes. It should have been entirely about Gabe.
Yeah, I know.
Shouldn't it?
No, this is why I don't like fandoms, because they just... Here's what fandoms want. Something completely new that's exactly the same.
They don't know they want it, though.
Yeah, I know, that's the thing. Just let a creative person try something, and maybe you won't like it, but maybe you will. That's the fucking risk you run. Stop begging for the same shit over and over again, you dumb lumps.
When Silent Hill 2 came out, the first response from the fans was disliked because it was unrelated to the plot of the previous game. Those guys shut up after... a larger critical response got out.
I think it's overall been well established that Silent Hill, I think, works best in an anthologic, in an anthology kind of way. A slightly different story every time.
Yeah, it doesn't stop people trying to recreate Silent Hill 2 all the time. Which is missing the original point Silent Hill 2 made, of course, but there you go. There's nothing more blind than the people who have exposure to everything. People who,
more
have access,
less sequels.
People who have access to all the resources in the world. There are none more blind than that. We can create whatever we want. So, obviously, we want to recreate excitement like the kind of thing that excited us.
That's, I suppose, George Lucas' problem there.
I guess. He's always trying to, recreate, the pulp films of his youth, isn't he?
Mm-hmm.
But he's shit.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. He's a humdinger.
I mean, if he did just want to tell, the basic fairy stories like these pulps were, like the original Star Wars was, Rescue the Princess, And that'll be fine, you know. Simple morality tales we can all get behind.
Yeah.
Here's a really evil villain who's made everything shit. Here's the plucky hero.
Simple story well told, like it is.
Here's the plucky hero from humble origins. There's none of that in the prequel trilogy. It's just confusing bollocks.
Well, yeah, the prequel trilogy.
Because George Lucas had
pretensions
to suddenly make things more complex. Like Count Dooku, who the fuck was that? Was he a bad guy?
So terrible. So fucking terrible.
Because there are times when he was trying to make a straightforward melodramatic fairy story within the trappings of a more complex drama. People being really insanely angry for absolutely no reason.
Like, character was a huge... Character motivation, in-universe character motivation. Like all of his character motivation was non-diegetic. He had to have it external to it. The characters did things because it was necessary to the external world of the film.
Exactly, like Anakin Skywalker being really cross at Obi-Wan at the end. Why is he really cross at Obi-Wan?
Or just...
Just answer that one question for me. Why was he really cross at Obi-Wan at the end of...
His entire arc is just things happening because they have to... You know, for the rest of the film to go ahead, not because they make sense within the film as constructed, which
is
really
evil.
Shitty.
He becomes evil because he's got to become evil. Yeah, that's why he starts, like, becoming a bad apple in the second film.
Even though he was meant to have been one of the greatest Jedi ever and seduced by the dark side, he acts like a total fucking shit stack for the entire fucking series.
Yes, you should all watch the Mr. Plinkett reviews of the Star Wars prequels. They're great.
They're good to develop a sense of... Like, if you haven't done any kind of lit crit or anything like that, the Plinkett reviews are a good way of getting an idea of critical literacy about sort of film and stuff in general.
I just think they're so good at editing, those guys.
I find the little vignettes and skits kind of stuff really shitty.
I think the little things they do in their reviews, like just to recontextualize a single image is really good. Like there's one bit I was suddenly thinking of. There was a scene where, I think it's from the third film, where Anakin is talking to Palpatine in the opera, and Palpatine says something like, "Evil is a point of view." And it turns to Anakin looking at him curiously, and over that they just added the sound of multiple sirens going off.
Yeah. Why not just do this? Why not just do this? There's millions of ways you could have dealt with this in-universe without fucking this up, but the story had to have a fuck-up, so they just wedge it in.
And the love story as well. These characters have to fall in love at some point, so we're just going to do it in the most forced possible way.
I think one of the most egregious examples of this from recent times was Star Trek Into Darkness. Those guys just started holding hands. Star Trek Into Darkness, where they've spent an entire movie with two villains. So, yes. Khan doesn't actually look bad, really, at any point in this movie. So they literally call Spock, old Spock from the other series, to explain to the audience why Khan's bad. That is one of the most shittily written pieces of character I've ever seen. Because at one point he crushes a guy's head, and you're like, well, that's pretty evil. It's like, yeah, but this was the evil guy that he killed. And he killed him for revenge. So it's like, well, that's not really bad then. You know, he's not really a villain in that arrangement.
Well,
and they forget, they completely forget to characterize Khan as a villain at all throughout the film. And they literally tell the audience. They literally call Spock and go, why is this guy bad? I go, Khan is the most evil person we've ever dealt with.
Really?
He looks, seems pretty reasonable to me. I mean, you know, he's kind of insane, but...
You know, it was a good film. Huh? Demolition Man.
I love that movie.
You knew who the villains were in that, didn't you?
Yeah.
It was Christopher Lee who was controlling Wesley Snipes.
It was Mr. Humphreys from Yes Minister.
Are you sure?
100%.
I seem to remember it being Christopher Lee.
I guarantee you I have watched that movie recently. It is not Christopher Lee.
You're probably right. I'm misremembering that, but that guy was basically playing a Christopher Lee role in that film.
Yeah, I can see that.
And
I want money. Be money.
I think we lost sight of the original goal at some point.
Well, yeah, because someone didn't unlock the cities.
You are not going to blame me for that. I'm not going to play this game for however many hours you need to
hey,
get past. Hey,
Artsy, do you have San Andreas? Because otherwise I'll download a fucking ISO and we'll do it that way. Yes, I have it on Steam. Do you mind playing to unlock the areas? Sure.
You said to play just one or two missions and it'll unlock after that.
Well, to be fair, I thought it would and it didn't.
Right,
so I guess
exactly.
We're both wrong.
And I had shit to do.
Like play other games?
Well, yes.
I have an essay on Euripides to write. Although I know a fair bit about it, so it's okay.
And how relevant is that going to be to the lives of millions? I'm writing reviews about games millions of people are playing right now, and who want to...
You are someone who wants to actively be remembered for their creative work as opposed to a genetic contribution to the species, and here I am saying I'm writing a fucking, you know, essay about a guy, you know, almost 2,500 years old who wrote plays. Like, yeah. You want this to happen. You want to be Euripides.
How many essays about Euripides have been written in the past, though?
Fair few. He's a tragedian from
ancient Greece. So what are you contributing?
Well, it's not about new contribution when you're doing second year uni subjects, for goodness sake.
Oh, of course.
But
it
one
is.
day, if you are lucky, that'll be you. They'll be talking about Yahtzee in second year university subjects Mars.
And how do you see yourself contributing to the world?
I don't give a shit. Existence ends in dust.
Well, of course it will be, if that's the attitude you take.
Well, no, but I mean, you know, one day we're going to either evolve so far beyond our current understanding of humanity that it'll be meaningless, or we'll go extinct, and at any rate, the vacuum death, you know, the heat death of the universe will take it all anyway, like...
Right.
You shouldn't worry. Like, you just don't worry. It's meaningless, but that's not inherently a bad thing.
I'd say it is our duty as a species that has evolved to this point to see how far we can evolve.
Oh, I would agree with that too. So, you know, I'm you know, gonna have kids one day eventually when I'm like maybe 50. I'll have them like Letterman.
I mean, if it turns out that life is as rare in the universe as it appears at this point, then our existence justifies the universe. The universe is a spectacular thing. We may be one of the few things in the universe capable of observing and contemplating it.
That was one of the things I really liked about Red Dwarf, was humanity being alone. And just how crippling that was for the species.
Well, that wasn't really my point, but yes.
Well, no, but you know what I mean. Like, like Red Dwarf dealt with that sort of concept, particularly in the early series, where there's no aliens. We were it.
They kind of figured their own way to do aliens after a while.
Yeah,
though.
They, you know, the Gelfs and stuff like that.
No, really, they were man-made. They're out here in deep space, hate humans and act nothing like humans, but they were man-made, so we haven't broken the rule. But I think that's following the letter rather than the spirit of the law.
Yeah, that's...
I mean, they wanted to get away from goofy costumes. They wanted to make it about simple character drama between individuals locked together in space.
Philosophy and science fiction. It was why it was, you know, the first two series are my favorite because they really stuck to that.
It's like how the whole beach ball alien section in Dark Star feels really out of place.
Don't eat it! Dark Star is one of my favorite John Carpenter movies. So good.
And one of his earliest as well.
Yeah, the first part he made in college. And then he finished it into, you know, finished sort of crafting it into a full feature film. That's why the guys have beards and shit at some points.
I am fond of it.
It's a very good movie. Download and watch Dark Star if you haven't watched it.
Well, this was quite a meandering conversation and meandering exploration of San Andreas.
Yeah.
But we've hit our limit.
Well, let's recap. This has been nothing but waffle, I think.
Pretty much.
I had a different plan. It was going to... There was going to be just riding around, there was not going to be shooting, and it was going to be enough that every now and then you'd see a new location, and we'd have something to talk about in-game, and then we were going to be able to wander to a goddamn topic.
Well, as I said, I'm not taking responsibility for this.
Now I'm fucking running around in my underwear, shooting people in the back of the head, trying to get money for a fucking haircut.
Which is exactly what everyone does in GTA.
Yeah, exactly the sort of dumb shenanigans that we were trying to avoid.
We've sold out... What have we become?
Quick, monetize this video. That's
next, we're going to be ending these with like and subscribe screams.
Like and subscribe.
Like and subscribe. Please. Like and subscribe.
Please. Hey, you know what, Yahtzee? We should have, like, face cams. Wouldn't that be a thing? Like, then people could see us and we'd be more personalities that they could relate to.
But if people saw your face, they'd be really put off as they attempt to masturbate to my voice.
Consider it a challenge. Then maybe we could play, like, a game that was frightening, and people would be able to laugh at our humorous responses to scary circumstances.
The annoying thing is, that would be incredibly popular, and everyone would love it.
Yeah, and then, you know, I could finally give up on this fucking teaching lark. You could ditch writing books, and we could make our money as popular YouTubers.
See, the difference is, I want to be writing books.
and I want to be a teacher.
Writing books is the lesser part of my income. I'd like to be... I'd love to be able to do nothing but write books.
Well, most authors have, like, even good ones have, like, second little things that they do.
Yeah, it's really, really hard to make a living solely from writing books these days.
Sadly not easy.
Although I did want to mention this, actually. Mogworld is currently on the Humble ebook bundle.
Woo!
Although you do have to pay more than the average amount to get Mogworld.
So do you get other books with it?
So do that. Well, yeah, it's a bundle.
Well, that's, you know, you're not just paying for Mogworld. No.
I think there's a book by Cory Doctorow and one by Will Wheaton.
Oh, you're in some fine company there.
I know, right? And if you pay above the average, I'm one of the bonuses you get. Mogworld, well, not me personally, Mogworld. I don't come around your house.
Yahtzee will come to your house. He will absolutely come to your house. He will look at you with his... somewhat stunted social understanding. It will be incredibly awkward, and you'll regret ever having met him.
But if you haven't read Mogworld or got the ebook, now's the great opportunity to support charity, get a bunch of other ebooks, and also support me and encourage me to work harder on the book I'm currently writing.
Are you at liberty to reveal any information about said current book?
Now, this is harsh territory, because the next few words I say will probably be dissected ad nauseum.
Okay, do it.
It's a book about wanking on a clown's face.
I was honestly not expecting that.
It isn't really.
Damn it. I'm disappointed now.
But yes, get the Humble ebook bundle, support charity, and me. And,
maybe you could just, like, I don't know, donate, like, $5 or $10 to me. That'd
good night, listeners.
Just crowdsource me.
End of video. Go away.
Go do something with your lives.
Yeah, unlike Gabriel.